You're watching UNICEF Television. Education was first up at the Millennium Development Goals Summit. At an event organised by the Global Campaign for Education, a 12-year-old girl from Soweto made a simple request.
Please help as politicians. You have had an opportunity to go to school. Now you are here and meeting at the UN. Please make sure that 69 million children get the chance to go to school.
Her Majesty Queen Rania of Jordan appealed to governments to make investing in education in the developing world a priority.
Education doesn't just beat poverty. It beats disease. It beats inequality. And for girls, education is nothing less than a lifesaver from stigmatism, insecurity, and violence. It's the issue that cuts across all others.
She was echoed by the former Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, Gordon Brown.
I am angry about the waste of opportunity and potential in education in so many parts of our world today. But I am inspired by so many people who want to make possible in our generation, for the first time, the right of everyone to be able to go to school.
In response, the World Bank announced that it would allocate an additional $750 million to countries that are lagging in their education goals. And UNICEF Executive Director Anthony Lake emphasized that helping the poorest is the most effective way to get every child into primary school.
We need to concentrate not just on the hardest to reach nations, but the hardest to reach areas, because those are the areas of the greatest need. A recent UNICEF study shows that in health terms, and we believe is true in education as well, it is more cost effective to work in these areas because that is where the needs are greatest and the payoffs are greatest.
Later in the day, Mr. Lake attended a panel discussion sponsored by the Global Alliance for Vaccines and Immunization on the challenges of immunizing children against disease.
I'm hoping that this year at the MDGs, one of the things that will become increasingly prominent is the importance of pneumonia and diarrhea, the two leading killers of children that for years have not really been at the top of agenda. And from where I stand from and looking at the data, I think the road to the MDGs goes right through pneumonia and diarrhea, and there is so much that we can do.
The Gavi Alliance has prioritized the introduction of vaccines over the next 5 years.
We're really working on child mortality and to some extent maternal mortality. As you know, maternal mortality is a long way off track, and child mortality we need to do a lot more in some of the poorest countries.
UNICEF is using community-based, low-cost programs such as oral rehydration, antibiotics and micronutrients to attack these diseases. This is Chris Niles reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, visit unicef.org. Unite for Children.